Welcome to the module biopolymers. My name is Lars Blank. I'm a professor for applied microbiology at the RWTH Aachen University. Here you see our building, which is located in a vibrant environment between natural science and engineering at Aachen University. In our research and teaching, we are interested in the contribution to a bioeconomy where we investigate chassis cells, equip them with novel enzymes, express them in regulatory modules, think about transport issues, and at the end want to increase yield, weight, and titer of these microbes from renewable resources, here a simple sugar, to a more valuable product, which is here terephthalate, the T in PET, in your PET bottle. Actually a molecule you will hear in this module more often. So the idea is that we rather use crude oil to all our daily products, that we use renewable resources. And this is also the scheme of this module about biopolymers. And the idea is that we discuss and think about the sustainable biopolymer production. To do so, we first have to introduce what are biopolymers. So a definition that you are aware what biopolymers are. And then their properties. And there are different classes of biopolymers. And you can think about them as plastics, because these are the major part of biopolymers. And the plastics you use in daily life, around the clock, in all situations of your life. And the idea again would be that instead of using crude oil to produce all these products, that we use renewable resources to produce the same products, or products which have a higher functionality. And these examples we would also like to discuss. Again, from a definition to the properties to the examples, and we will end with some outlook what can be envisaged in this kind of area, how to produce the biopolymers sustainably. For example, there are ideas use plastic waste, you know, all this collection of mixed plastics, and produce something more valuable out of it in form of a biopolymer. I hope that you go with us through the whole journey of this interesting module.